Good morning.
Morning.
How are you guys?
Good. How are you?
I'm okay. Okay, I'm okay. How you guys feeling?
I feel good.
You're good? Back happier?
Yeah, I'm just doing a lot more stretching. I think I'm just more cognizant of the things that tweak it. So I've been a little more intelligent in with my exercise. Working out with Ben yesterday too really helped, where he pointed out some of the things that I was doing. So that's helpful.
Good. Yay. And today's the last day of work?
No, I have Monday, Tuesday. Yeah, we've had some issues at work. So
Sorry.
Yeah, today's technically technically it's my last day for 2 weeks, which I am thrilled about.
Yeah,
but we'll see.
We'll do half our dance now for
right
you, Cornelia.
We'll see if it actually occurs. That's the key. We'll see if it actually happens.
I see. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. I feel like all the fires happen now.
Well, with email and phones, there's just too much that, you have, there's no boundaries.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Boundaries are gone. Unless you just throw your phone in the woods and, hey, that's my boundary. You guys stepped over yours. There's mine. Make sure you have a backup phone, though, because I'm sure you'll regret it right after you do it. Hi, Oren. Good morning.
Morning.
How you doing?
All right. I forgot my computer, so I will be.
All right. We haven't done much this morning. We're just chatting. We're going to get warming up, though, right now. Anna just pulled in. Colette, your back's feeling good. Any soreness? Cornelia, Oren, feeling all right?
Yep.
Morning. Anything extra tight this morning?
Calves. So the calf, perfect Friday calf workout.
Oh, yes. We'll get those babies blood pumping right through those muscles. Yes. Okay. All right. Let's get started. What were you going to say?
Forgot to ask Cornelia, my dad is trying to place the face and the name.
It was when fundraising for the Center for Jewish Life at Dartmouth, way back when, so many years ago.
All right.
Yeah. I work in Dartmouth in fundraising. So it's been like a gazillion years, but I totally have such a picture of him. And such a open, goofy guy. So yeah.
Yep, that's him.
Yeah.
Excellent. Cool. Thank you.
That's cool. He didn't just like, yeah, okay. I remember her.
I know. I'm like, and you know when you're certain people you just remember really well. And it's been over 20 years or whatever, but yeah, I'm still at Dartmouth just to let him know that I'm still in fundraising at Dartmouth. So
I will.
Yeah,
I'll see you today, actually.
Sweet. Say hi.
I will.
All right. Yay. Let's get moving. I'm going to mute you guys. Of course, you guys, any questions, throw them at me. If you want any modifications, make it easier, harder. Yes. Oh, I do have a quick announcement for you guys. Not that you want to hear this on this Friday, but the InBody is in house, set up, ready to go. If anyone is interested, well, it's like, what the hell is an InBody? Is a body fat muscle water weight machine. So it basically tells us how much fat we have, how much muscle we have, and how much water we have. It's actually very interesting information if you can separate yourself from those numbers. But it is in-house. If anybody's interested in coming in, just let us know. Okay, shoot us a message, and you guys can come in anytime you guys want to. All right, hey, let's start. Just start, Deb. We're going to start on the floor as usual. And we're going to go on our back. Right, and we're going to drive the hips to the ceiling. And we're going to march, pulling the knee in, scoring. Deb, I just sent you a whole bunch of messages. Yeah, you're good. Pulling the knees in. Good morning, Vanessa. Okay, I've got to push to the whole foot, pull knee into chest. Almost there. You guys, good. Go ahead and you can finish your last one, and then let's go ahead and grab a long band. And with our long band, we're gonna go around the foot. And then nice and slow, let's take the leg straight up, and then we'll hold here. So straight leg, soft knee. Deb, how do you feel?
Pretty good.
Did you get my messages?
What's up? So good.
Did you get my messages?
No, I heard it go off.
Okay. Nice and easy, guys. Let's take it out to the side. Right, keeping hips flat to the floor. Good, last one, we'll pull cross body. Breathe, breathe, breathe. And let's switch to the other leg, guys. So we'll go around the arch of the foot, mid foot. Soft knee, straight leg. Hold, breathe.
Didn't look hard enough.
Huh? No. You were just right. Guys, take it out to the side. Take it out to the side if you haven't. Stretch out those hammies this morning. Good, and you guys can take a cross body. Last one.
The same happens
because
I go off to the house, and anytime I even
land
on the floor, one of my cats is like,
oh, hey, hey. It's time to play. All right, guys, let's come up on our feet. And what we're going to do is a walking hip hinge. Okay, so it looks like this. I'm going to take a short step, push my butt to the back wall, reach for the toes. Up, right, so each step, right, exhale, hinge. We're gonna go 30 seconds. Okay, and if you guys run out of space,
Let's go when you're ready. You can go backwards. So inhale, exhale, hinge. Don't force your reach, guys, okay? When you feel hamstrings stop, giving you motion, range of motion, right? I'm right about here. I don't want to force it rounding, right, with that lower back. Almost there. Okay, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Good. And you guys can finish your last step and rest. All right, so we're going to take it back to the floor. Okay, and what we're going to do here, guys, is I'm going to rock my hips back just a little bit. Okay, I'm going to take my right hand. I'm going to reach through, drop shoulder, rotate up. Okay, we're going to go all one side first. Okay, big inhale, big exhale, reach, rotate. You guys got to keep going. Go 30 seconds each side. Let's go ahead. Last one, then let's switch to the other side. Okay, plant a hand to the floor. Inhale, reach through. Exhale, reach, rotate. Good, you guys. Go ahead and finish your last one. Okay, and we're gonna just kind of bring it up from this position, butt back to our quadruped position. Okay, and we're gonna do a little side glute. So we're going to do hydrant. So just push knee out, right back in, heel to butt. We'll go 30 seconds. Breathe while you're there, guys. Breathe while you're there. Good, and switch sides. Let's switch sides. Get that other glute.
Did
you hear? Or is it the light? I just like it. I hadn't done that the weeks ago. It's always the light. Almost there, guys. Almost there. Great job. Rest. And we're gonna actually come back to our feet. And what I'm gonna do, you guys, so I want you to imagine I'm going to go to the wall. Okay, and you're moving. Imagine there's a wall in front of me. Okay, so you guys are gonna do this either in a doorway or a wall or something. So I'm gonna go hand, wall. Okay, pushing palm in, butt and hips back. Okay, single arm shoulder mob to rotation. Butt and hips back. Slowly rotate those feet away from the wall. Inhale, exhale. While you're here, you can hold any position you want that feels good. Walking your feet out.
out away from the wall. We're almost there. Okay, go ahead, finish your last one. Then go ahead, switch arms, right? Plant that hand, push palm in, hinge, armpit to floor, lock those feet out. Almost there, guys, almost there. Good, you guys can finish your last one. Okay, what we're gonna do is, good, a couple more, side to side. Okay, hops, 30 seconds. If you want, you can take a bigger hop. Okay, up to you. Small side, 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 hop. Good, 30 seconds. Soft on your feet. Breathe. Good, you guys, and rest. Rest, rest. Okay, two more. So first one, if you guys want to use something for a little bit of balance, you can. Okay, foam roller, wall, couch, stool. We're going to do a single leg, okay, ground reach, ground touch. Opposite hand, reach. So I'm working left leg, right hand reach. Okay, you guys go ahead and use something for a little stability. If you want, grip the ground with that foot. Good, 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 you guys. Good, nice soft knees. That's okay. Good. Switch sides, guys. Switch legs. Grip with the foot. Right. Reach that opposite hand. Butt and hips back. Soft knee. Great job, guys. And you guys can finish your last one. Oh, that was a nice stretch, Cornelia. Yeah. Okay, last.
That's not.
She just, it's probably been about 2 months now, maybe. She rescued. Okay, last one, guys. You guys can do this two different ways, okay? So, push up position, you can go knees, okay, shoulder. Touch. You can come up off the knees, right, in that push-up position. Just tap, tap, tap. Okay, we're gonna go 30 seconds. Do what you're comfortable with. You can go knees, okay, or full push-up position. You can either modify that as well and do as long as you can, push up and then go to knees. Totally okay. Just breathe. While you're there, little tension in belly. Breathe, breathe. You got it. This is the last one. Good, you guys. Go ahead and rest. Beautiful. Okay, so we'll start our self-assessment, self-love. Okay, so wherever you guys want to start, okay, you can start on the floor, right, wrists, spinal waves. You can start with our toe touch, right? Just make sure you are breathing. Give me 3 to 5 breaths. Or if you want,
right? You guys can make this more dynamic. Walk hands out. Right? Walk hands back in. So either one toe touch, 3 to 5 breaths, or you can do 5 walkouts, then our deep squats. 5 to 8 deep squats, or you can do, right, 5 to 8 squat to stand. Our overhead reaches, big reach, guys, straighten those arms, maybe lock the elbows out, we can really get into the lats. Final waves, 8, inhale, exhale. Anything else you guys want to stretch out?
No, I'm sorry about that. No, it's kind of messed up. And I don't know what's going on. I was on some of them yesterday for a while. I was at the home phone. Before that, it was like 24 hours of an email back and forth. If you would look, you probably would have seen it and it went away, but it was there for a long day.
Yes.
I'm going to email the demo, Deb. I'm going to email you the PDF.
Oh, okay.
That way you have PDF.
Guys, throw in some wrist stretches if you haven't. We are going to start, okay, with our flow first. Then we'll do our calf, our knee, shin stuff. Okay, so first what we'll do is just a little, kind of little warm up, 2 scorpion reaches or 2 full scorpions, okay? Guys, this may change each week, right? Like last week you might like not stressful, was blue easy, you felt great, but this week may be stressful. You may be tighter, right? You may not be sleeping very well. So you may change this up week to week depending on how you guys feel, okay? So for this first one, you can either do, okay, your right scorpion reach, or you can go your full right scorpion, which will take you to your beast position. So, or a crab position, sorry. So you guys can do whatever you feel comfortable. 2 reaches or 2 full, okay? Then we're all going to start our flow together, 2 minutes. Like I said, if you guys, you know, depending on how you feel, you do not have to do the full flow. You could pick 2 to 3 movements to do, right? Flow those, right, for the 2 minutes, instead of trying to do all of the movements, okay? So don't take yourself too serious. Don't beat yourself up. And maybe have a little fun with it. So I'm going to go over the movements real quick, okay? The flow. And I'm going to start doing it with you guys during the 2 minutes so you can kind of see me, right? And then you are going to finish strong. Okay, so beast. You guys can do a loaded beast if you want. So beast, under switch. kick through, right? That same leg, then I come scorpion, crab, right? Back to my beast, under switch, kick through, scorpion, I'm going fast. Okay, so I'm gonna start the timer, guys. You pick 2 to 3 movements, right? Maybe, or you go through the whole sequence. Resting spots, beast or crab. You wanna rest, beast or crab. All right, let's go. Timer started, right? Beast, under switch, back. Kick through, same leg, scorpion, to your crab. You guys got it back. You may find yourself moving around your room, except for Oren. He doesn't really have that room to do that. But you guys may find yourself going in circles. That's okay. That's what you're gonna do. Think toes to heels, right? And that transition.
Yeah.
Trying to slow that scorpion down as you fall. You're over the halfway mark, guys. You're over the halfway mark. Remember, you can rest in a crab position or a beast position.
Yeah, that's what I
hope. 30 seconds, guys, remembering. What I usually can tell is how my arm is feeling. If that arm is feeling tired, right? Because I just did my score or under switch that way. I then switch into my kick through.
That
helps. 10 seconds. Beautiful, you guys. Beautiful. We're going to take a long rest after this. Starting now. Rest. Shake out those wrists, arms. Great job, you guys.
Wait, how are you guys doing?
Yeah. I encourage you guys sometime maybe take a video of yourselves doing a flow. Colette, come on. Okay, we better, I'll share a video of myself doing this, learning this. It's very, very silly. I'll share with you and then you guys can take videos of yourself and share with me. I like taking videos because you can definitely see changes and you can see your strengths and your improvements even though you may not feel that. Okay, so guys, we're gonna go into our calf raises. Okay, 25, your right tibialis raises, 25. And then your knees over toes, 25. Make sure you push through the heel. Then make sure you push through the toes.
Actually, I'm gonna give you a letter. If you want it instead,
So 25, right, bend our knees over toes. So little squat, right? And we're pushing up. Through that toes. Okay, when you guys finish, let's get ready, get your stuff ready. We have a shoulder elevated hip up or single leg hip up. We have a single leg, opposite side, single arm row. And the tall kneeling rainbow slams. Okay, so you may need a pillow, weight.
We've got box, army got box. We've got some number of weights for our rows.
So while you guys are doing your shoulder elevated hip ups, okay, mid back, thoracic spine, mid back should be in your, okay, your whatever you're using, your box, your step, stool, bench, okay. As you guys come up and down, everything should follow, meaning head, torso, hips. Okay, so if I'm here, everything's straight, right? We come up, look up, right? Let that head move with those hips, right? Or you guys got single leg, make it a little harder. 10 to 20. Step back, okay? You guys should feel hamstring, butt, maybe one more than the other. Okay, then we're gonna go to our single arm, single leg row, which you guys can do on the wall or with something for a little support if you want to. Okay, so we're just gonna pull straight up to the hip. Does not matter what you guys do with that, right, non-working leg. It can hover the floor. You can pull it up a little bit. 8 to 15. That's good. Selection. I know, I tried to do a selection of it them all, so that way. If you felt like higher, you go lighter, you go heavier. The last one, right, is our tall kneeling rainbow slams.
They both have a head.
Our tall kneeling rainbow slams, or for some of you, halos, right? We're in a tall kneel position, either toes or no toes, right? We bring pad up, around, right? That head, open those abs, slam. Okay, 6 to 8 on each. Right, up, up. Okay, for those of you doing right halos, think right open, kind of punch. 6 to 8, guys, 6 to 8. Colette, that's a freaking huge pillow. I love it. Orin, yes, yeah, good.
Tell us, feel bad. This up, keep looking, okay? Here.
up a little bit. Because, you know, it's a lot like reaching overhead, right? And that everything would be right, like the stretched out. So, guys, you finish your right rainbow slams. We're going to go back to your hip ups, bilateral, both feet, right? Or single if you want to make it harder. Ten to 20 on both legs or each leg. Then your single arm, single leg row. Vanessa, nice, you got it. Nice flat back. On your rows, guys, think little tension in the belly, right? A little tight core so the back stays happy. The butt mostly? Your butt mostly?
Well, sort of. Should I have my butt there?
No, I'm just curious where you feel it.
Sort of a little area.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I can feel around my whole hip, pelvic girdle.
10 to 20, guys, on our hip ups. Okay, 8 to 15, right, on those rows, grip with the foot, little tension in the belly, kind of pull. So on our sleeping, we try to place instead of the tall kneeling, this tall kneeling rotation instead of that. And we still get that rotation, but not an overhead rotation. Eight to 15 on our rows. 6 to 8 on our tall kneeling slams. Right, come up. Back up. On those rainbow slams, guys, if they feel easy, right, as they get easier, what I would want you to do is then go faster, as fast as you can, or slam as hard as you can, right, as fast as you can. So we just try and speed it up a little bit, right, or make it a little more dynamic. We're gonna do 3 rounds through, you guys, 3 rounds before we do our B stance RDLs with a pause. The only thing that I would say is as you kind of curl up to your hips, kind of thing, pull in belly. Yeah. And what that'll do is just get a little bit of front, like a little bit of lower pelvic floor. You'll be able to squeeze the glute muscle a little tiny bit harder. On it, that's look better.
Yep.
Feel the same thing? Twingy?
No.
Okay. Yeah, there are like 4 movements for you. I'm thinking that. Because you still want to work the core. It's just, this is a little harder working for isolating 4 movements. As the baby gets bigger. I think sometimes that's important. You guys got it. 6 to 8
Three rounds through. You guys deserve rest. Take some rest. 20, 30 seconds. Water break. Heart rate's down. Vanessa, you got it. Yes. Great. Overhead. Colette, that looks good. Let me know if you feel anything in your back. Cornelia, you ready for the next? Okay, good, Colette. Vanessa, that feel okay? Looks great. Slam somebody's face, Colette. Slam somebody's face. Come on. So Colette, or anyone that is ready, or Cornelia, you got your RDL. Okay, V stance, RDL, hinge, 1,000, 2,000, up. So you're just gonna give yourself a little pause, okay? Feel the hamstrings while you're there. 10 to 15. Warren, is he off? Is he off? Off of school?
Wrong day.
Huh?
Wrong calculating weights because I'm keeping track same time on the same phone. No school.
Multitasking skills are impressive. I love it. Yeah, last one. Yes. So in those RDLs, you guys feel hamstrings. You can hold on to the weight with one hand if you want, or two, whatever feels most comfortable, right? Hip hinge, hamstring, little pause, up, squeeze butt. You want to have two, or you want one kettlebell, or so. On our RDL V stance, you can go both hands. Okay, button his back, little pause, or you can go single. Okay, yeah. So go stick to what you're using in that single. Okay. I've got you at 10 kilograms, and then I think the other one's 8 kilograms. But actually, you know, I'm going to give you a bigger collar. That way you don't have to reach down this way. Last one on. Same way. Colette, back okay? Okay, good. Good. After your RDLs, guys, you have a rolling floor press. Good. Rolling floor press. Or rolling floor press to elbow. Okay, so either this. Well, that we can use your band too. I can show you how to use your band. Okay, or you guys can push up right through that elbow, rolling back down. So either just press, roll, or we press, roll, elbow. Yeah, what about that? You can look at it. And then you can give you 8 to 12 guys on each arm. Yeah, or I can say give you one of these. They kind of go over your arm so that the kettlebell kind of rests over your watch or over your wrist. And or if that's light, Deb, I got magnets, so I can add to max that dumbbell you have. Make it about 10 pounds.
Yeah,
what do you use to weigh at home?
Probably just like a 5 pound.
Yeah, so go with the 8. And then we can go up if it's easy. Call that good. You got it. Yep. Press, yes. Roll.
Take that elbow. And then take this heel to butt, closer to butt. And then as you press and roll, you want to keep this knee stay straight up. And then you press straight to the ceiling. Yes. You guys, your head will move with your body as you press and as you roll. Guys, the last one, okay, of this series is a front plank foot lift. So you're just lifting the foot straight up, or front plank jacks. Right, we jump out to the side. You guys pick lift or jack jump, 5 to 10. Okay, then we're gonna go back to our RDL, B stance with a pause.
Something different. That's the one exercise that really hurts my back.
Could you try going out to the side instead of lifting up? So just a small, call it just small, right? Side toe tap. If you still feel that though, stop and let me know. And your compressed, so we'll do one more each. Yeah. 10 to 15 on our RDL with a pause, little tension in belly. Squeeze butt at the top, guys. And then 8 to 12 on our presses. 5 to 10 on our front plank leg lift or jacks. You got it, Vanessa. That's half of the workout, is losing your balance. And then recovering with 25 pounds in your hand. Cornelia, great job. That was so graceful. Oren, good, right up on that elbow, beautiful.
Okay, one. Lengthen.
This motion probably
would be. Oh, this must be my. I think that's the only one that I can really feel.
This motion probably would be really kind of weird, and this motion will start to feel weird. So I also sent you a link. I send you messages in two places. So you can get back to me.
Thank you very much.
Sorry. Whenever you have time.
Yeah, sorry about that.
No. I could tell you were like, I'm ready to do this. What the hell?
I mean, I can almost cut it.
Yeah.
Anyway.
See you maybe? Next week, maybe, or?
Yeah, what are you guys doing?
we only changes we have to schedule is
we have only a 9 o'clock class on Christmas Eve day. But other than that, we don't have anything else for your that's the only change. Thursday class we're all the same.
Okay. I'm gonna post it too today so everybody has it.
Yes, my day.
Guys, we're almost done. You're doing great. You guys got it. 10 to 15 for our RDL. 8 to 12 on our press.
What?
I said you can go faster.
Well, no, we said not to.
Oh, okay.
Because of the test this morning.
Okay. I just did, I was.
No, I, and, yeah, normally I wouldn't want to make the noise.
Okay, I didn't know if you were just.
That's a little bit slow.
Noise here.
You cut your hair.
I did.
A lot.
I did. It feels great.
Yeah, Diana won't.
It took me quite a while to.
Well, she's just 50. She's 50. She's never going to cut it because her hair.
Well, I thought my hair grows so fast and thick that I needed to, it was just kind of like dry and I needed to cut it and have some new growth.
Yeah. Yeah. My hair keeps me warm.
Well, that's it. I
would never get it short.
I needed it to be at least on my neck, so.
Me too.
My mom used to cut my hair very short when I was a kid. Like very short. So I'm kind of like
I would never do that. I would freeze to death. This is like part of my scarf.
Oh yeah. Almost done, guys. Some of you are wrapping up. Go to our finisher if you're ready and feeling good.
Yeah, when I want air conditioning, this is what I do when this is my air conditioner. I cut my hair like every year. Yeah, I'm like, it'll pull me up a little bit.
It does. And I can't wear a hat in winter. I know. I because I get so hot for me. And when I'm skiing, I just.
Sometimes I do, but I feel like I'd rather wear a hat than a lot of layers.
Yeah. Ponytails.
Yeah. So on our finisher, guys, we have quadruped donkey kicks. Let's just crush them. All right, quadruped. Band around the knees, heel to butt and push. It is not about how high you go. It's just about how much we can utilize, right, those glutes. Then apple pickers. Then banded squats, body weight, or you guys can add a jump if you want to. And apple picker, right, is on your back. Back is flat, head tucked, let it reach. Pull shoulders up off the floor. I used to pull it like this. I had like bicep shoulder pain from that.
Yes, body weight squats, you guys. Colette, how you doing? Almost done. Cornelia and Vanessa, great. Not letting the band pull you in.
On a list of what is like time, there's still reps. So it's going to give you like 10 to 20 reps for all of them. So the donkey, the apple picker.
If that one no bothers you at all, let's switch that one.
I'm gonna
sure call it. You gotta go. Okay.
Yeah. But thank you. Have a great weekend.
Let us know. Send me a message or us a message if it starts to feel tight again or anything. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Have a good weekend.
Bye.
Guys, got it. Quad donkey kick.
Heel to butt. Right. Push.
Jamie, can I ask a question?
Absolutely.
So when you say send you a message, what is the best way to send you a message?
Well, I think you opted out of our text, so I can't send you a text.
I tried to opt out of all the.
Yeah, so either. We took you out of all the text messages, but then we just have a member text. So like, we'll probably text out our holiday hours.
It's all right to put me on that one.
Okay. I think you opted out. So I'll figure out, see how I can get you back onto that. The other thing, we'll post the same message in the app.
Right. So, but if I wanted to
send me a message to the app too.
If I wanted to contact you.
Yep.
Should I do it through the app? Should I email you? Should I text you?
If you want to contact me directly, you could send me an email at Jamie, the same email I send you guys your PDF. If it's a question like about billing or a program or something like that, you could pop it in the app, but you could email me as well.
Okay. Multiple ways to communicate is really overwhelming me right now. So I'll just email.
The app is used for all program questions, whether it has to do with any exercise or program, we generally want to use the app, right? Because I can go in your program, I can look at the movement, the exercise, and then I can respond to you rather than looking at the app and then going to my email.
I don't use the app for the programs. It's too hard to figure out. I just use my PDFs. Those work beautiful.
just you can email me. Send mass communication messages out through email. So anybody can email me, absolutely.
So for the text, it's fine if you're sending like schedule stuff or this is camp, you know, that sort of thing, but it's the join us for this program or whatever that I really am not interested in.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful weekend.
Yes, you too. Good job today. I'll see you Monday.
Yes.
I've got to find those other bands. I'm going to go search later on those ones that don't roll up.
Oh, oh yes. Yeah. Vanessa has a good set.
I got them from TRX. Those are mine.
Can you show me them? Do you have a picture? Can I just see it? And they don't roll up?
No. Well, okay. They do if they get bunched up, but they once you get them set straight, they work pretty good.
Yeah, they look wider. The other ones now, I guess they're worn out. They're just rolling up and it's just cutting. It's like painful. It's like a rubber band.
So these are the ones that I use that work pretty good. They came with my TRX, so I didn't have to buy them, but I'm pretty sure you can find them on the TRX website.
Thank you. Much appreciated, Vanessa. Have a good weekend. Thank you, Jamie. Bye. Everyone have a good weekend. Take care.
High five. Good job, you guys. Warren, you got it.
That's one of the things that was really important to me was I could pick clothes up like as long as I could, you know what I mean? Like 8 to 10, and you know, like I'll carry on my back and go hiking or something like that because hopefully trauma. Build strength too. Plus we were doing all the mud runs and stuff. So. I did that.
there's a couple.
Yeah.
All right, almost done. Breathe through. You got it, Warren. You got it. Almost done. Did you match your outfit this morning to your band? I like it. Yeah, we gotta be color coordinated.
Always.
Always, that's right. Actually, you know what? These days I'm going for not. Just wear it.
No. I think it's because I own a lot of black. My hoodie and my sweats were also black/gray today.
Yeah, I realized like a year, 2 years ago that I looked at my stack of like hoodies and stuff, they're all like grays, and I'm like, I need color.
Yeah, I think my next hoodie, my next Upper Valley hoodie is definitely going to be a pop of color.
Well, maybe even tie-dye.
Like that. I like that.
Good job today, Warren. Huh?
Crazy.
Tie-dye's everywhere now. It's like everywhere.
True. Every trend always comes back.
I know. I'm waiting for the big 80s bangs.
Ooh, yes.
I'm not sure that one will make it. The hairspray might.
Maybe some too. Pick. Come back. He'll get.
All right, Warren. Okay. Good job today. High five. And I'll see you next week.
See you next week.
All right. You have a good day.
You too.
Bye. Bye.